As you may know, the world is a very, very dangerous place, and the science lab is no exception.
Ow! Hey, dude?
Yeah?
Hydrochloric acid smells pretty good, dude.
If you don't know lab rules, you'll probably end up like the guy behind me. That dead guy didn't follow a very important rule in lab safety. And this leads us to rule number one. Never inhale chemicals directly. Oh, hello there. Back again so soon. Well, I guess this leads us to our second rule. No horseplay in the lab. Studies show that horseplay can lead to accidents. If you don't believe us, just ask our paid professional.
Huh? Sorry, wrong guy. Anyways...
Here we have a classic example of horseplay in the lab.
Michaela.
What, Esteban?
Meow.
You know that ticks me off.
Meow. You're such a pyro. So as you can see, horseplay in the lab is just not a smart thing to do. You can save yourself 5 minutes of pointlessly heavy breathing. And a bruised knee. Moving on, this leads us to rule number three.
I'm okay. Have you tried this?
No.
Was it?
Yeah, I don't think you should be eating, but whatever, your funeral.
But you're good.
So how are those crackers we were eating in the lab earlier? They look pretty good now that I think about it. You got any left?
No. Katie?
This could have easily been avoided had she not been eating in the lab. Not only is eating in the lab unsafe, but it's just not the smartest thing to do. This leads us to our fourth rule. Always make sure to label chemicals correctly. If you don't, well, here's an example of what could go wrong.
So according to these instructions, we're not supposed to add water to the solution.
Which one's the water?
It's this one? Ah, screw it, nothing's gonna go wrong.
Hello.
This leads us to our fifth rule. Always make sure to have your hair and loose clothing tied back or constrained.
Oh, my hair's on fire!
Oh my gosh, are you okay?
So this leads us to our sixth rule. No open-toed shoes in the lab. Well, old sport, it's just not the smartest thing to do.
in the fire. That was a perfect example of why you need to know where your lab safety equipment is. For example, there is a fire blanket that is an example of a first aid kit, and there is your typical fire extinguisher. These items just might save your life, or would you rather say,
you could die without these items.
Oh my god, the bell just rang.
What are these chemicals?
I have a good idea.
Always be sure to use goggles because, well, rock stars use goggles.
Good thing I was wearing goggles.
This leads us to our next important rule. Always make sure to clean up your station. Because a dirty station, well, it's just not cool. Alright class, time to clean your stations.
We should get the janitor to do it.
Yeah.
In conclusion, if you follow these rules, you have a good chance of surviving the lab. So, a lab experience should be safe and fun, not dangerous and explosive and it just gets messy. But, you know, just follow our rules and you'll be good. Or not. All stunts are performed by our actors. No stunt doubles at all.
Believe me on that.
One action.
Go.
One action.
Hey, you there. Be sure to use. Sorry, guys. That was my eHarmony video. Just don't look at that.
Well, this is a very, very dangerous place. And if you're not careful, you can have a good guy. Okay.
Go.
In the past I would try hard to commit to a girl, wouldn't get too far. It always somehow seemed to fall apart. But with you, I could see what I need. I could dream realistically and knew that this was different from the start. And it seems that every time we're out of eye, I can find. This has been Safe Science in the Classroom.